right?
Okay.
Because I just want to get everybody knows what we are doing. Yeah. What is your questions, Abdul Qadir?
Sir, and level two, we assume that the temperature is low, because it has high thermal activity. But I didn't really understand why.
Say it again. So this is because of this, Abdul Qadir. You know that as we in these equations, we consider that the temperature of the rod is the same from the top to the bottom. That one is for the level one problem. Okay, right? You understand, right?
Yeah.
Can you see this one? It's from the top to the bottom is the same, but in the real situations, this is not true, because there should be a heat conduction from the from this part into the top. Okay, and then because the mixings in the gas phase is also not as well as the mixing in the liquid phase. Okay, you understand?
So it means in the liquid phase, the change would be negative.
No, that in this level two equations, it's a little bit we relax the assumptions of the first part of this A. Okay, but we retain the assumption for B, C, and D. So only the first part is being relaxed, okay? But in this assumption, we assume that the rod temperature is uniform from the bottom to the top. In the level two, we still take the temperature is uniform from the bottom to this interface in here, okay? But the temperature of the rod from this part into this part in here is no longer uniform, okay?
Mm.
Why? Because there is a heat conduction from this point to go to this point. And then beside the heat conduction, we have a convective heat transfer from the surface of the So meaning that the temperature at this point will most likely will be different with the temperature at this point, and then will be different with the temperature at this point, and will be different with temperature at this point. Okay, yeah. So yes. That's why we take in the cylindrical in your rod, we take a thickness of a slab of a thickness delta x with the same surface area with your rod. Okay, and then in here, we assume that there is a heat, a heat conduction. Yes, Abdul Qadir.
QX is the conductance and LX is the distance, right?
QX in here is the heat that comes in from the bottom part of your slab element. It's basically a heat that goes into your slab.
Okay.
And then this QX at X delta X is basically the heat that comes out from this part of the slab. So imagine you have this slab, okay? This slab with the thickness of delta x, okay? And then you imagine that at this position the distance is x, because at this particular position in here, x is equal zero. So your process start from this particular positions in here.
Yes.
Okay, and then this particular positions in here is called x. And then this particular position in here is called x plus delta x, because your shell has a thickness of delta x. Okay?
Yeah. Yeah. This one I understood it, but later in the balance in n and meter squared joules per second meter squared. I didn't understand joules per second.
This unit is a unit of the heat flux, Abdul Qadir, because heat flux is referring to the heat flow divided by the area. Okay, heat flow. Heat flow is written as a capital Q. So heat flow has a unit of joule per second.
So this is joule per
This lowercase q refers to the heat flux, okay?
Yeah.
Flux.
And then LX flux, is the point of the distance.
This X in here just after the Q is the heat flux in the directions of X. Okay.
Okay.
And then these things in here, the line in here is inspected, evaluated at X.
Oh, so it's not a different variable. It's not a different
variable. No. This is inspected at X.
I thought it was. I was confused.
No. So this is this QX inspected at X plus delta X.
Okay. So it's like
so this is notation. Like this is a notation. This is a notation.
Yeah, like the tensor where it's X and Y and X Y and Y and Y and
Yep. So this line in here is actually a notation. This is inspected at X. This one is inspected at X plus delta X.
Okay.
Where else can I help you with Abdul Qadir?
What's the difference with convective transport?
Is related with the bulk motion of the fluid. Momentum transport is basically regarded with the velocity within that particular system. Okay, so
let's say it again,
Abdul Qadir.
Don't try to relate
the convective with this concept. This is more on the generalization Newton law of viscosity. Okay, the thing that you need to relate with your molecular momentum transport is this figure in here, Abdul Qadir. This figure in here is basically showing you that if there is a velocity gradient, a velocity gradient within your fluid. So if let's say the surface in the bottom in here is being dragged by a velocity of v, okay. So at very large time, then there will be a linear velocity profile developed from your top plate that doesn't move with your bottom plate that doesn't move. Then there will be a momentum transport, okay, from these directions to the bottom directions. And the momentum transport occurs in here because there is a difference in the velocity within your system.
So it goes from
Yes, that is from the high to the low. So the momentum transport is from the bottom to the top, right? Mm. So that's called the molecular momentum transport. Okay. Whereas convective momentum transport is related with the movement of your fluid. So if you have a fluid that is moving, okay, with the particular velocity, then there is an associated density with that, okay? So that's why in the molecular momentum transport, density is not a factor, but in the convective momentum transport, then the variable density in here appears.
Okay.
Because there is a bulk motion of a fluid, so a part of the fluid moves as a whole from one place to the other place, whereas the molecular momentum transport is concerned within that part of the fluid itself that has a different velocity.
Convective is about the
the way that you visualize is that convective momentum flux is related with the movement of the bulk part of the fluid, whereas your molecular momentum transport is more into
the profile.
What is happening
profile.
within that bulk fluid itself.
Yeah, because there's a lot of equations.
I know. Yeah. That's why I'm telling you to bear with me until you go into the example. Then in the example, you need to try to understand the equations into the context of your
tutorial. The tutorial question.
The tutorial question.
Okay. It was quite different from.
Okay. Abdul Kader, which subject have you passed? You passed already fluid mechanics and then chemical engineering thermodynamics, isn't it?
Yeah, this is my first semester.
This is your first semester or the second semester? This one is
first.
No, right? You
first.
This is your first semester.
Yes.
Oh, inter year.
Yes.
Okay. But you have done another subject in our program, right? Before this one.
Yes, I finished fluids.
You have done process heat transfer or not, Abdul Kader?
No, I have not.
Oh, okay, okay, okay. I see.
Yeah, this is the first.
It's okay. It's okay. You just try to, like I told you again, you try to derive it again, and then go into the lecture video recording, because I try to explain as much as I can in the lecture video recording, and then I'm happy to answer any questions with you in sessions like this.
Thank you so much.
No problem, Abdul Kader.
Okay, sir. Have a good day.
That's it. Nothing else again. Okay. Yep.
Yeah.
Okay, you too. Have a good morning. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. See you. Yeah.